Hi, I'm Will. I'm a Paleolithic archaeologist, and today we've presented a whole series of videos going through all different types of technologies, and we've been hoping to show you how they interact and how people use these technologies to interact with the whole environment. We spoke about flint tools and experimenting with flint tools and how they're made and discovering how people may have gone about them and how they may have used them and how they may have produced them. And whenever we see a piece, as an archaeologist or an experimental archaeologist, we read it and we hope that you can start looking at pieces and seeing how they were made as well. Following that, we looked at organic materials such as cordage and how it could be applied in making fire or making basketry or making traps and the importance it must have had in everyday life. We do not find a lot of this in the archaeological record. However, we know that it was present in everyday life. It must have been there. And we assumed that through experimentation, we can work out ways it may have been used. We also have animal matter, such as antlers, that were not only carved out for musical instruments, but also used as percussion instruments for making stone tools, for artistry, for people would carve them and design them and shape them in different ways. To do this, once again, they'd fall back on stone tools and other elements that were harder than this material. And it was this interaction of all of the materials that was brought into everyday life. Another aspect is this knowledge of their environment, their local environments and the larger environments, and notably the geology, finding different types of stones and minerals and metals that they would use to make fire, to make tools, and how they'd go out into the landscape, recognize these pieces and bring them back, carry them around with them in everyday life. So the overarching theme that we wanted to present today through these different videos was the complexity as well as the variety of elements in the landscape that people would interact with and learn to use. And through this knowledge would be able to live within the environments of the past.